Hey guys, Hariki Play here. I'm back with another unboxing slash review video. Though it's not really an unboxing slash review video because I don't have the original product packaging, but I'm here to talk about this Pokemon toy, which looks might not look familiar to a lot of you because this toy is back in 2006, which is very old to me since I was young at that time, quite young. I'm trying to see if you can get see or not. So I'll just tell you. 2006, Pokemon Nintendo, TMNR Nintendo, 2006, Bandai, made in China. So this is an, I don't know the name, so therefore I'm just going to call it Nintendo Pokeball toy thing-ish. So as you can see, the physical aspect of the device. It uses a lithium battery, CR2032, but it also fits with CR2025, and it's a 3-volt battery. So I got it from a local shop for $1.80, which is not that cheap. So here is the housing place for the battery. The reset button is here. I don't know what this does. This is the trading port for you when you connect with other players with the same console. This button, so button for the front and back is the same. The right side is either cancel or back, select or enter for the middle button, and this is just to scroll through. Same for the front. So when you start off, open up, see this interface, and this is a glass screen, plastic glass, I think plastic, yeah, I think it's plastic screen. And as you can see, it's a retro display, and the sound is also retro since it's 2006, you must remember. So you get to choose 4 Pokemon: Bulbasaur, Pikachu, Squirtle, and Charmander. In this phase, you can use both buttons to choose. I don't know why there's Pikachu, but these are all Gen 1 Pokemon, and you can evolve them by battling. You could catch Pokemon, I think, but this is a later time, and you get to unlock a few more stuff. So I'm just going to show you first. So let's say I want Charmander, which is kind of my favorite Pokemon. And this thing here is the one that do all the mechanism when you close the cover. This thing here has nothing to do with the game. It doesn't even have wire or anything, just plastic piece, and you can take it out. So press once, it'll start flashing. It's like the yes or no screen. If you don't want Charmander, press the right button, cancel. If you want, the flashing screen, select it one more time. And you selected Charmander. The screen itself, as you know, this plastic can see through, it's translucent. So when you play this console, play in a good lighting area with a clear background like white in color. That's why I put it white. So you get to choose 4 languages: English, France, German, and Spanish. So you can use the left button, the right button does nothing. So we'll select English, of course. So there's 2 parts when you're playing the game, the front and the back side. So for the start, you're not at the front screen, although you can see the back, it doesn't work. So for the front, idling mode is just Charmander moving around. So you have 3 options. The first one is your bag. This is where you store your antidotes, your poison cure, and your sleep of revive thingy. You know, like the same in the console, the Game Boy games, whereby you have your revives and everything. So you scroll through using your left side, select using the middle button, and this is the cancel button, so don't always click the right button unless you want to cancel. This is the stats, I think. Yep. Your level 3 and your main is a fire. So I think one arrow means like level 1 power. There's 2 and 3. So the more arrows you have, the more powerful your attack. So you have 2 attacks. And this is the battle and trading system, which requires another console, which I don't have. Anybody know the name of this? Comment, put it in the comment section below. I would like to know. Or if you have the same device that I have, also comment down below, it'll be interesting to know. So to trade, you need another player which will be facing this way due to its nature of the button. And you press enter. Let's say you want to trade Charmander. Confirmation screen, yes. Then we kept the Pokeball and we'll show you the console trading and we'll start the trade. And we'll start connecting, trying to see if there's another device, but of course there's nothing here, so it will show you the cancel screen, error screen, but I'll just cancel it there. You can cancel the trade, I guess. So that's pretty much it for the front part. The back side is a bit dark to see, even for the camera. Because of its nature, it's very dark. So, enter, there's two. For the start, there's two. One is your Pokédex / Encyclopedia book, since it's like a book, and the other is the Adventure. So, Encyclopedia book, yeah, you can get to see your stats. The button itself is a bit old, so. This is Charmander, and I guess you can do something with lighting. Hold on. I guess I can't do much about the lighting, so you have to bear with the like this. So, select Charmander. And you get to see it's a retro way Charmander. The name, it's 0.6 meter tall and weighs in at 8.5 kg. This is the Pokédex / Encyclopedia, and this is the Adventure button. Select, upon selecting, you'll see this screen for a starter, and this is the Govani Gym. If you can see the bottom left here, it's a house with a dark roof. Shaded, this is the Poké Center, and you press once. This sounds mean that your nurse Joy has healed your Pokemon and you can leave. Unlike the game itself. So as you can see this dot moving around. The map, these are all the wild area we can go and find different types of Pokemon. As you move about, when you see something like screen flash, this is where you met trainers. So it's on PG. How to activate your Pokeball? Very simple. Not by just flipping this, it will not work. It will keep beeping. So what you do, there's a ball mechanism inside, so you shake. You hear that? That's the mechanism thing. And you show your open Pokeball. So open up. And Charmander's here. So first round you have to fight, and this is the selection mode. You have to, there is a time limit for the select, if not it will auto select for you. As you can see just now it did auto select for me. So the attack is not strong, and the PG itself I guess is also not that strong. Oh, it is, so we are about the same level. So you can run. And to go back to your adventure, just show you back the screen. As you can see, this building with a white roof here is actually a gym, and it's a Govani gym. So when you select, there's nothing happen. As you can see, the button is also I don't want gym. I don't want wild trainers or I can't cancel him away. Is it the right button or the middle button? One of the two buttons will cancel away, just like wild Pokemons. So, I know this video is lengthy, but just bear with me, as it takes a bit of time to explain everything and show you. And this is a 2006 console. Sometimes your Pokemon will dodge the attack by itself. Sometimes the enemy will dodge it, then you have to click how many times the arrow. So go to here. You can see it beeping down here. So we select it. This is in the forest team. So that's north, south, east, west, and this is the radar itself. So for now, the Pokemon is very far. This is already nearer, but you need another bracket more. Like this. Ah. And here comes the bean sprout thingy, I forgot the name. So you shake, open up, Charmander. So fight, flamethrower. The face icon that you're seeing now is which means when you attack nothing will happen, so don't select that, it's bad. And fire against grass type is very good, very effective. So see, one, so we can try and see if it level up. Not yet. So back, when you are not playing idling, it's like that, you can just leave it or close it by itself. So your adventure begins by fighting wild Pokemons and wild Team Rocket or trainers. You can actually can deny them by clicking either the middle button quickly or the right button. And after you have, level up something, you can proceed on with the next map also. Yeah, because you won't be stuck at this map for long. After fulfill some requirements, yep, and you can proceed on with another map and just keep moving. So it's you training just like a normal game, except this is much more simplified version. There's also Elite 4, if I'm not wrong. You can capture Pokemons, but I forgot how, and this is really just from pure memory, if I can remember. And so that's pretty much it for the console itself. Hope you guys enjoy this strange Pokeball toy thingy that I think most people don't have, or have but throw away long ago. And the only other video I found of this same console was a very poor quality video and was spoken by a kid. So that's the only video, and it's blue in color. So I'll put links if I can find on the description below, on the blue color one. You can find. Hope you guys enjoy this informational video. If you enjoy, please give it a like for its Pokemon and Pokemon Go. Subscribe for more content. I mainly do World of Tanks Blitz, reviewing / unboxing video. I have to wait. It won't be very frequent because you need money to do so, and you find contents which I really have to find. Comment down what you think about this console. Do you have one? If you have, put it in the comment section below. Or if you know the name, it'd be good to know about the real official name. I can't find the official name for this console device. And I'll see you guys on the next unboxing video, I guess. Hope to see you guys soon. Subscribe.